coming up in this special edition Brightline construction update. This special Brightline construction update looks at days 9 through 12 of the installation of the Cocoa Tunnel, which occurred from March 23rd to the 26th, 2021. The Cocoa Tunnel is located at the interchange between State Road 528 and US 1 in Cocoa, Florida, and is where Brightline's new line to Orlando will separate from the existing Florida East Coast Railway main line to head west. We'll start here on day 9, March 23rd. Our last update, which you can view the link above, left off on day 8 as crews were preparing to pave the eastbound lanes of State Road 528 going over the tunnel. At the time, I thought they were going to pave two lanes and relocate both lanes of traffic onto them. Well, as you can see today, they only paved one lane and relocated the eastbound traffic onto it. This tunnel is being installed using a method called box jacking, which uses hydraulic jacks to push prefabricated tunnel segments into place. This installation is special, as it is the first time in North America that segments have been pushed into place while there's active traffic passing on top of it. This is possible due to an anti-drag system, which is a series of metal plates laid on the roof of the tunnel segments with a lubricant underneath, and held in place by the dark blue frame straddling the tunnel. Moving over to where the first two tunnel segments are being installed, you can see the various light blue rods and beams that are making the push. The jacks themselves are mounted on the edge of the tunnel segment, pushing back against the large dirt pile. Crews look like they are preparing to start pushing the segments again. Crews in white protective suits are checking on the lubricant that is being applied to the tunnel roof as it moves forward. Up on the road, crews were removing barriers that had been used during the rerouting of the eastbound traffic so demolition of that lane could occur. Looking inside the tunnel, you can see pieces of the beams that are being used in the push stacked up, ready to be dropped into place by the excavator as the segment travels forward. The yellow crane is getting ready to remove the temporary retaining wall in the path of the tunnel. Moving on to day 10, March 24th, and there was a lot of major progress. Most noticeably, Segment 3 had moved laterally to be alongside the combined segments 1 and 2, which are already in the process of being installed. Those segments were also on the move, having moved forward at least the width of a lane of traffic. With the segments moving forward, crews were able to bring in dirt to start forming the second lane of traffic on the eastbound side. A sub-roadbed material had also been put into place and was being spread and compacted throughout my flight. Crews had also removed the temporary metal pilings and retaining wall that had been alongside the inner westbound lane to prepare for more forward movement of the tunnel. The lateral movement of the third tunnel segment had been quick, with some of the rods already removed. Even with all of the specialty heavy machinery involved with this project, the shovel still plays a role, as this worker demonstrates along the edge of the third segment. Looking down at the rods and beams here gives a good look at how far the segments have moved. The silver bars straddling the blue rods are to help make sure the blue rods do not buckle while under pressure. Once the second lane of traffic opens on this side, crews will begin the process of demolishing the westbound lanes and excavating the earth beneath it, so the tunnel can continue to move forward. Even as night begins to fall, crews will continue to work 24/7 until this project is complete. Let's move on to day 11, March 25th. The second lane had been paved, and westbound traffic moved onto it. With traffic moved, crews had begun demolishing both of the old westbound lanes. This is a two-excavator operation, with one digging dirt out from in front of the tunnel segment and piling it up for the second, which will then load dump trucks to take it away. Here is what it looks like to drive across the tunnel in both directions. The third tunnel segment got some kind of black coating applied to its roof. As of when this video is published, I do not know why that was done or what the purpose is. The two combined segments did move forward slightly today. Here is one of the dump trucks taking some of the dirt away from the excavation. Here's a look from the north side of the excavation in progress. Moving forward 24 hours to day 12, March 26th, and there were not many changes to report. The combined segments only moved forward a minimal amount. The excavation continued as well, but there is a lot of dirt that still needs to be removed. The worksite was fairly empty as well, with the fewest number of vehicles parked around the site that I have seen since the installation began. You may have noticed that there are two tracks passing the worksite. The track on the left is the lead for the CMEX City Point plant. Using a balloon track that loops through their facility, a complete unit train of rock from Medley, Florida is unloaded 6 days a week to supply the booming construction industry in Central Florida. The track on the right is the existing main line, and a second main line will be built on the right of it. Here is the daily look down at the jacks and rods. Here is a look down the right-of-way the tracks will follow, and the ramp the tracks will climb as soon as they exit the tunnel, so they can go over Industry Road. I have received some questions asking what these piles are south of the construction site. These are brand new concrete ties produced by Rockla at their plant in Fort Pierce, Florida. They are being stored here until crews are ready to start installing the tracks. From the north, here's another look at the excavation progress. That will bring us to the end of this update. Remember to follow my social media pages for daily updates on the construction progress until my next video on the installation. Thanks for watching. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe. Also check out my social media pages.